start there. Let's start with this parish donating 245 backpacks to Samaritan House. Yeah, you can clap for them. That is the work of the bread. And the people, so we hear they get to their boats and they go over to Capernaum and they're looking for Jesus. Jesus has gone on. He's moved on. He takes space for himself. He takes time to move forward. And the Gospel of John is filled with misunderstanding. Have any of us had misunderstanding in our life of faith? Oh my gosh. That is the life of faith. But understanding and misunderstanding again and again. And what Jesus tells us in this Gospel is abide. That word belief really means trust in Jesus. Not like thinking in your head, this guy's God. That's a cool notion. But faith, that abiding, journeying, showing up together throughout a pandemic, throughout his life of faith, in those moments of loss and joy, abide. Abide. Lean into me. Support one another. And so they come across in their boats. They say, Rabbi. He wasn't a rabbi. Misunderstanding again. And they refer to his ancestors. That great story, Moses praying to God, crying out to God. Why have I led these people here? And the interesting thing about that manna that comes from heaven is it requires trust. So it's this dusting on the ground, right? But they can't save it. They can't hoard it and say, we've got enough. They have to hope and trust and pray that they will wake up again the next day and there will be manna. We are invited into this daily abiding. And like I mentioned, this is your time to eat bread, if you eat bread. But I invite us into a prayer practice of that evening. Whether it's bread or the beautiful fruits and tomatoes and basil and vegetables, to take a moment. Before we put that food into our mouths, to look around. Look at the things we have around us, the people we have around us. And to take a moment to take a breath and to say thank you. Thank you for the abundance, whether it is meager or plenty, thank you. This journey of understanding and misunderstanding invites us not into a knowing, but into God showing up. God showing up, being present with us. In our doubts, in our worries, in our celebrations, showing up again and again, and hopefully in new dimensions, in new ways of seeing God. I was listening to a podcast that was noticing the research, the full researchers that found that fewer and fewer people are going to church. Now, nourishment, that deep well to be with